السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، عباد الله، my dear brothers and sisters, today, we live in a time where the scale has completely changed, upside down. Today, we have different understanding than what is supposed to be the right understanding in our Islam, in our deen. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we are unified under the so-called game football, but divided within our relationships, within our families, by Islam, by having the Islam. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we go against, and rightly so, the alphabet gangs. But on the other side, we are happy to watch half-naked people on our screens. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we visit the social media every day, every minute, but we don't bother to visit our relatives, our family members. This is how we have understood things that are completely incorrect Islamically. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, my topic for this khutbah, for this Jumu'ah, is related to something that is very, very important in Islam. And given the fact that many of us are going through the period of holidays, winter holidays, where we have more time compared to the rest of the year, where we have more time to look after about something, to fulfill something that is short in our lives. And my dear brothers and sisters, today's khutbah is for everyone. It's not for someone who is just non-practicing. It is not for someone who is away, far, far from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is for both those who are practicing and those who are not practicing as well. Because all of us, we fall short when it comes to upholding the ties of kinship. When it comes to maintain the ties of kinship. When it comes to silatul rahim. My dear brothers and sisters, today's topic is silatul rahim. And there is no religion that has emphasized on maintaining the ties of kinship, upholding the ties of kinship, than the deen of Islam. My dear brothers and sisters, and this is a reality, which is a sad reality. How many of us, we know our fathers or mothers, brothers or sisters, especially if they are back home? When was the last time we have spoken to our uncles and aunties? When was the last time we have visited our grandfather or our grandmother? When was the last time we have met with our siblings? Especially once we got married, we are busy with our spouses and kids. When was the last time we were sitting together in a family gathering? And all of us, we know the answer. Either we are busy at work, studies, and so on and so forth. And we forget that silatul rahim is obligatory upon all of us. Maintaining the ties of kinship, upholding the ties of kinship is an act of worship, my dear brothers and sisters. And it is obligatory upon every single one of us. And my dear brothers and sisters, in-depth study of Siratul Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we find out that one of the most important commandments in the earliest days of Islam was about looking after the family, was about tying maintaining and upholding the ties of kinship. There are three main incidents that have been mentioned in the seerah of Ibn Ishaq. Number one, Amr ibn al-As, when he came back to Mecca from Yemen, in the earliest days of Islam, he found out there is a man who is preaching a new message. So he looked for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he found him, he asked him, "Who are you? What's the message you came with?" He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I am a Nabi. I am a prophet." And he said, "What is a prophet? What is Nabi?" He said, "Sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a message." So he asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "What's the message?" The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "An ta'bud Allah wa la tushrika bihi shay'a." You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and you associate no partner with him subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, "وَأَن تَصِلَ الرَّحِمِ," and you look after your family members in the best way possible. Another incident, my dear brothers and sisters, in the earliest days of Islam, is the incident when the Muslimin, they have migrated to Abyssinia, to Habasha, and Al-Najashi, who was the king of a Christian land at that time, he asked Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu an, who was the leader of the wafd, of the delegation of the Muslimin, of the believers. He asked him, "What's the message that the messenger, that your prophet came with?" And the answer was similar to what the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Amr ibn al-As. He said, "The message is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to avoid the false god and be good with our family members, with our relatives." The last incident, my dear brothers and sisters, was the incident when the message of Islam sent to the king of Rome. And Abu Sufyan, radiallahu an, he was not Muslim at that time yet. And he was visiting the king of Rome at that time. So the king of Rome, he asked him, "What's the message that this new messenger came with?" Even though he was not Muslim, He was not Muslim yet. He knew the clear message of Islam. He said the new message this man came with is to worship Allah alone and to avoid every single false god, to avoid worshipping idols, and to be good with our relatives, to have a strong family connection with our family members. So this was the message, my dear brothers and sisters, in the earliest days of Islam. And I would like all of you, my dear brothers and sisters, to remember this strong hadith of Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the universe. And when he had finished, kinship, ar-Rahim, stood up and said, O Allah, this is the standing. This is the standing up of someone who seeks your protection from being cut off. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, would you be pleased if I were to take care of those who take care of you and cut off those who cut you off? The kinship, the womb, the rahim said, Bala, ya Rabb, of course, my Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, then your dua is granted. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in this hadith, Iqra'u in shi'tum. Recite if you wish. فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ أَن تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَتُقَطِّعُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فَأَصَمَّهُمْ وَأَعْمَى أَبْصَارَهُمْ. Would you then, if you were giving the authority to do mischief in the land and cut your ties of kinship, those are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed them. Abdul Rahman ibn Auf radiyallahu an, he's narrated the hadith, which is an authentic hadith. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ana ar-Rahman, I am Allah, Ana Allah, Ana ar-Rahman, I am Allah, I am ar-Rahman, I created the kinship, I created the womb, and I named it after my name, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. So whoever keeps good relationship with it, I will keep good relationship with him. And whoever cuts the ties of kinship, I will cut him off. This is the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear brothers and sisters. A man, he said to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Rasulullah, direct me to a deed that may submit me into al-Jannah, into paradise. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon hearing this, he said, أن تعبد الله ولا تشرك به شيئا. You worship Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and associate no partner with him. وأقم الصلاة, and establish the prayer. وآتي الزكاة, and give in charity. Fulfill your duty of zakah. وصل الرحم, and maintain the ties of kinship. My dear brothers and sisters, there's a beautiful hadith, especially for those who look to increase their rizq, who want to have a long life. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من سره أن يبسط له في رزقه وينسأ له في أثره فليصل رحمه. Whoever would like to have his rizq increased and his lifespan to be extended, then he should maintain his ties of kinship. This is one of the reasons, one of the means, my dear brothers and sisters, to increase our rizq, to extend our lifespan by maintaining and upholding the ties of kinship. And my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us against cutting the ties of kinship. In Surah Al-Ra'd, وَالَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةُ وَلَهُمْ سُوءُ الدَّارِ. And those who violate the covenant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it has been affirmed, and sever the ties of kinship that they are commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to uphold, and their mischief in the land Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed them. And there is a home waiting for them in Jahannam wal'ayadhu billah. My dear brothers and sisters, what could be the severe punishment than the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a home in the hellfire for those who curse the ties of kinship? And in another hadith, Allah's Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he warned us, he told us that there is no sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rushed to punish it in this dunya in addition to what is stored up in the hereafter than the injustice and cutting the ties of kinship. This is something very serious, my dear brothers and sisters. مَا مِنْ ذَنْبٍ أَجْدَرُ أَنْ يُعَجِّلَ اللَّهُ لِصَاحِبِهِ الْعُقُوبَةَ فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعَ مَا يَدَّخِرُ لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْبَغْيِ وَقَطِيعَةِ الرَّحِيمِ. No sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rush to punish you in this dunya, and in addition, what is stored up for you in hereafter than being unjust and cutting the ties of your kinship, not having any relationship with your relatives, not upholding the ties of family members. It is a major sin, my dear brothers and sisters. And we have to understand what it means to uphold and maintain the ties of kinship. It means to have a good relation by exchanging the gift, by visiting them, by inviting them and accepting their invitation, by making dua for them, for the relatives, by having a heart that is clean towards them. And one of the most important things in tying the kings or in upholding the ties of kinship, my dear brothers and sisters, is to guide those who are misguided, is to enjoin the good and forbid the evil. This is the duty, my dear brothers and sisters, when it comes to maintain the ties of kinship. Now the question arises here, how far we can go in this system? Who are our ties of kinship? Who are our kinship? And generally, the most strongest connection we have with those who are most closest to us. And the most closest to us, number one, my dear brothers and sisters, is our mothers. Our mothers, they have more right than anyone else. We have to look after them. We don't have to get busy when we are married or busy at work. And then our fathers, then our spouses and our children, then our siblings, our brothers and sisters, then our paternal and maternal uncles and aunts, and so on and so forth, and then their children. This is, my dear brothers and sisters, a duty of every single one of us to keep it uphold. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى وبعد. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, what we have to know, what we have to learn when it comes to Silatul Arham, when it comes to uphold the ties of kinship, is that how often we should visit, how often we should see each other. And it goes back to the custom, to the society that we live in. And obviously, the more closest we are to our relatives, the more visits we should have. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, our maintaining the ties of kinship should be with the mahram relatives. What does that mean? It means those who are permanently haram upon us to marry them from men or women's side. For the men, their aunties, sisters, nieces, and so on and so forth. And from the mother, from the women's side, brothers, uncles, nephews, and so on and so forth. So these are the relatives we have to keep the ties up with them. When it comes to the non-mahram, the scholars have said it is mustahab, it is recommended to uphold the ties with the kinship who are not mahram. It is mustahab and recommended. But when it comes to the mahram, then it is obligatory to maintain the ties of kinship with them. Last thing, my dear brothers and sisters, we have to know on this topic is the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in which he said, "Laysa al-wasilu kal-mukafi." If, my dear brothers and sisters, we are maintaining the ties, we are upholding the ties, just because the opposite relative, they do the same as we do. They come to our house, we go to their house. They are good to us, we are good to them. This is the reason we keep the ties up with them. This is not what the Islam has asked us to do. Listen to this beautiful hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in which he explained what should we do when it comes to upholding the ties of kinship with our relatives. Whether they are good, whether they are bad, whether they are coming to visit us, whether they are boycotting or not coming to visit us. A man came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he said, "Ya Rasulullah, I have relatives with whom I try to keep in touch, but they cut me off. I treat them well, but they abuse me, and I am patient and kind towards them, but they always insult me." The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, upon hearing this, he said, "If you have said, and if you do what you have said, and if you have said is a truth, then what you are doing is you are throwing the sand on the mouth of those relatives who are evil to you, who keep insulting you. So this is what, my dear brothers and sisters, we understand and we learn. It is not about those relatives who are always good, nice, happy with you, smiley, and that's why you visit them, you keep in touch with them. It is all about those as well who are not good to you, who you get harmed by them, either with their tongues or with their actions. You have to be patient, you have to be kind, you have to keep visiting them. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, and he sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah will continue to help you. This is the most important thing. We should not give up. We should not give up upon those who are not visiting us, who are not good towards us, who are insulting us all the time. We have to remember this, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue to support us as long as we continue to do that, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us. Now finally, my dear brothers and sisters, there are some ways in which practically we can keep in touch with our relatives, with our family members. Number one, which is the saddest one, and that is find out who your relatives are. It is embarrassing that we don't know even our relatives. We don't know our uncles who live abroad, their kids, their children. We don't know our aunties, our cousins, and from our grandfathers and grandmothers' side, and so on and so forth. So my dear brothers and sisters, practically we have to find out. And the only way we can find out is by asking Sheikh Google. No, the only way, my dear brothers and sisters, we can find out is by asking our parents, by sitting with our grandfather and grandmother if they are alive, by having an informal interviews with them. This is a part of respect, my dear brothers and sisters, to sit with the elders, to listen to their stories. There are many benefits. There are many things to learn from their stories. And we have to ask them who are our relatives from the mother's side and from the father's side. So we have to sit, we have to ask. And if we don't ask, we won't be able, my dear brothers and sisters, to fulfill the obligation that we have upon us in terms of upholding the ties of kinship. And after knowing who are they, the easiest, the best way to have a chart where we have the family tree. And this is the best and most interesting way we can teach our kids as well. Where we have a family tree, they know who their uncles, aunties, cousins, siblings, and so on and so forth are. Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu, he said a beautiful, أثر. There is a beautiful أثر, a beautiful saying by Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه. He said, علموا أولادكم الأنساب. Teach your kids the lineage, who their parents, who their uncles, who their cousins are. He said, if a man gets upset with a person, but he knows that he is his relative, that he is part of his family member, that it would be hard for him to cut him off. But if he doesn't know, then it would be the easiest thing to cut that person off. And by cutting off means cutting the ties of kinship, which is haram. So we have to teach our kids. We have to know by ourselves first, and we have to teach the kids who the relatives are. Number two, my dear brothers and sisters, get in touch with them. Nowadays, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it the easiest way to keep in touch with our family members. WhatsApp call, FaceTime, Facebook, all these social media platforms are easy, even if they are abroad, to keep in touch with them. Make a call. Break the ice between you and your relative that you have never spoken to them. Get your parents involved to break that ice and keep in touch with them. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, if you know your relative, then spend on them if they are poor. Unfortunately, my dear brothers and sisters, we are happy to go online and give in charity by just having a one click, but we forget our relatives. If we know them, we forget them, that they are poor, they are suffering, and they are in need of our help, and yet we ignore them. Allah's Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when you give in charity to a person you don't know him or who is not related to you, then it is a sadaqah. But when you give it to someone who is your relative, who is related to you by blood, then it is not only sadaqah, it is a sadaqah and silatul rahim, and upholding the ties of kinship, which you will be rewarded for as well. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us among those who fulfill the rights of silatul rahim. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make us among those who uphold and maintain the ties of their kinship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us a one united family and ummah. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على خير البرية محمد بن عبد الله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم جنبنا الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين المضطهدين في دينهم في كل مكان. اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم احفظ لنا والدينا. اللهم أطل أعمارهما في طاعتك. اللهم ألبسهما لباس التقوى. اللهم ألبسهما لباس الصحة والعافية. اللهم فرج همهما. اللهم اشف أمراضهما. اللهم اشف أمراضهما. اللهم اشف أمراضهما. اللهم ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم ارحمهما كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم ومن كان منهم ميتا, اللهم فاغفر له وارحمه وعافه واعف عنه وأكرم نزله ووسع مدخله واغسله بالثلج والماء والبرد ونقه من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة, حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة, قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا وتراصوا. Straighten the rows, fill the gaps.
تم الصف الأول فالأول. Make sure the rows are filled, especially at the back, brothers. Leave no gap between you and your neighbor. Shoulder to shoulder and feet to feet. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يسبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض الملك القدوس العزيز الحكيم هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين وآخرين منهم لما يلحقوا بهم وهو العزيز الحكيم ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين قل يا أيها الذين هادوا إن زعمتم أنكم أولياء لله من دون الناس فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم والله عليم بالظالمين قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون
يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إذا جاءك المنافقون قالوا نشهد إنك لرسول الله والله يعلم إنك لرسوله والله يشهد إن المنافقين لكاذبون اتخذوا أيمانهم جنة فصدوا عن سبيل الله إنهم ساء ما كانوا يعملون ذلك بأنهم آمنوا ثم كفروا فطبع على قلوبهم فهم لا يفقهون وإذا رأيتهم تعجبك أجسامهم وإن يقولوا تسمع لقولهم كأنهم خشب مسندة يحسبون كل صيحة عليهم هم العدو فاحذرهم قاتلهم الله أنى يؤفكون وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا يَسْتَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لَوَّوْا رُؤُوسَهُمْ وَرَأَيْتَهُمْ يَصُدُّونَ وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَسْتَغْفَرْتَ لَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ لَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ هم الذين يقولون لا تنفقوا على من عند رسول الله حتى ينفضوا ولله خزائن السماوات والأرض ولكن المنافقين لا يفقهون يقولون لئن رجعنا إلى المدينة ليخرجن الأعز منها الأذل ولله العزة ولرسوله وللمؤمنين ولكن المنافقين لا يعلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله